Children, welcome to this video. Today we will keep interesting figures in front of the mirror and look at them and discuss the dotted line. It will be a lot of fun.
Dadaji, come let us play something.
Come, Pinku. Let us play a game with the help of a mirror today.
With the help of a mirror? How, Dadaji?
Pinku, can you fold this picture into two equal parts?
Yes, Dadaji. I can do it.
Wow, Pinku. You have folded it correctly. Now open this paper and tell me if you see a line formed due to folding.
Yes, Dadaji. And this line is dividing this letter into two halves.
How did you find it?
Dadaji, this is very easy. With the help of this line, we had folded this picture and it looked exactly half. The left half has covered the right half completely.
Well done, Pinku. Now just put this mirror on this dotted line and see what happens.
Oh wow, Dadaji, this picture is complete. Now I see the entire letter A in it. Dadaji, this is a lot of fun. Now I will fold this letter the same way and see it in the mirror. Dadaji, this is a miracle. Now it has been divided into two equal halves. The top half has completely covered the bottom half.
Now keep a mirror on this dotted line and see.
By placing a mirror along with this line, I can see the whole picture.
Okay, now look at the picture of this butterfly. Can you divide this picture in half?
Yes, Dadaji, like this.
Well done, Pinku. Keep the mirror and see if the whole picture can be recreated.
Yes, Dadaji, I saw the whole picture as soon as the mirror was placed.
Pinku, now you play this mirror game with these letters too.
Okay, Dadaji.
Children, all of you also write some letters on paper and divide it into half. Keep a mirror and see. Dear children, you must have had a lot of fun with the mirror game and must have learned a lot too. Do you know that this game can be played with any picture, not just the letters? The image formed on the mirror is called the mirror image. And a line that divides a picture into two equal parts is called a point line. In the next video, we will see this game played with even more fun pictures. We will meet in the next video. Thank you. Children, welcome to this video. So far, we have seen many pictures on the mirror by placing the mirror on the dotted line. In this video, we will see some more examples.
Hey, Pinku, you seem to be enjoying with the mirror. Come, look at this picture carefully and tell where the mirror should be placed on it, so that this flower can be seen completely on the mirror.
Dadaji, for this we will place the mirror along this line and it will look something like this.
Pinku, look. Does this picture look like the picture made on the paper?
Yes, Dadaji.
Pinku, look at this paper carefully and think, where else can you place the mirror so that half the flower is made on the mirror. Children, you also try and find out.
Dadaji, if we keep the mirror here, half of the flower will come on the mirror. Look, Dadaji, we can place the mirror here too. And there are many places like here and here and here too.
That's right, Pinku. Wow, Pinku, you have found all the places very well. Well done, Pinku. Now look at this picture carefully. Now can you tell where to place the mirror so that you can see such a picture on the mirror?
Dadaji, this is very easy. The dotted line will be at this place and look something like this on the mirror.
Well done, Pinku. Well, can you draw a dotted line on this picture and look in the mirror to find out whether it is divided into equal parts or not?
Dadaji, for this picture, we will place the mirror on top of this line and we will see a similar picture.
You answered this correctly. Can you draw a dotted line on this picture and look at it in the mirror to find out whether we can divide it into equal parts or not?
Dadaji, I will be able to do it this time too. In this picture, when we place the mirror above this line, then we will get such a picture.
You answered this correctly too. Now draw a dotted line on this picture in such a way that half of it is visible on the mirror.
Oh, Dadaji, this is a chessboard. I need to think a little about it.
If you want, you can pause the video here and give it a try.
I found it, Dadaji. Let's see this. In this picture, when we place the mirror above this line, then we will get such a picture.
Well done, Pinku. Now tell me whether we can place the mirror on some other line.
Children, you also find and tell.
Yes, Dadaji. See this.
Well done, Pinku. You have answered all the questions correctly. Take your reward.
Dear children, till now you have seen some examples and understood that if we place the mirror on the correct dotted line, then even the incomplete pictures are visible to us. And it is not necessary that the dotted line is always vertical, it can also be diagonal. This is where we end this video. In the next video, we will discuss some common mistakes related to it. Thank you.
Friends, welcome to this video. So far, we have seen some examples with Pinku. Now we will see the picture seen in the mirror with Pinku and some common mistakes related to the dotted line.
Pinku, till now you have seen so many pictures. Now I want to ask you some more questions. Will you be able to answer?
Yes, Dadaji, I will answer all the questions very easily.
Okay, Pinku, then tell me. Where will you draw the dotted line in this picture? By putting the mirror on one half, we can see the whole picture.
Dadaji, in this picture, we can draw the dotted line in this way.
Okay, Pinku. Now place the mirror in this place and see what is made.
Dadaji, it looks a little strange. When I face the mirror to the left, such a picture was made. And when turned it to the right side, it became like this. Why did this happen, Dadaji?
Because, Pinku, you drew the wrong dotted line. The correct dotted line will look something like this. Take this, Pinku. Now you see it in the mirror.
Yes, Dadaji. Now it is divided into two equal halves.
Pinku, always keep in mind that there is a different dotted line for every image. Pinku, look at this cartoon. Now place the mirror in such a way that both hands of this cartoon should be up in this way.
If you want, you can pause the video here and think.
Dadaji, this cartoon is very interesting. But how can both its hands be up? It has one hand up and one hand down, Dadaji.
Pinku, look carefully. If you place the mirror on this line and face the mirror to the right, you will get such a picture.
I'll keep the mirror once and see. Dadaji, both hands are up.
Pinku, can you now put both its hands down like this?
Yes, Dadaji. This time only the mirror has to face to the left and such a picture will be seen.
Dear children, till now you have seen how pictures change in front of the mirror. And you also learned that a dotted line is not always a vertical line. This line can be horizontal also. Now look at these pictures and tell, where should we place the mirror on this picture so that the following pictures could be seen? Till now you have seen how changing the place of the mirror changes the picture and also learned to recognize the correct dotted line. Hope you have learned many things from Pinku's mistakes. And now you know about this subject very well. With this video ends here. Thank you. Children, welcome to this video. So far, we have seen many pictures on the mirror by placing the mirror on the dotted line. In this video, we will see some more examples.
Hey, Pinku, you seem to be enjoying with the mirror. Come, look at this picture carefully and tell where the mirror should be placed on it, so that this flower can be seen completely on the mirror.
Dadaji, for this we will place the mirror along this line and it will look something like this.
Pinku, look. Does this picture look like the picture made on the paper?
Yes, Dadaji.
Pinku, look at this paper carefully and think, where else can you place the mirror so that half the flower is made on the mirror?
Children, you also try and find out.
Dadaji, if we keep the mirror here, half of the flower will come on the mirror. Look, Dadaji, we can place the mirror here too. And there are many places like here, and here, and here too.
That's right, Pinku. Wow, Pinku, you have found all the places very well. Well done, Pinku. Now look at this picture carefully. Now can you tell where to place the mirror so that you can see such a picture on the mirror?
Dadaji, this is very easy. The dotted line will be at this place and look something like this on the mirror.
Well done, Pinku. Well, can you draw a dotted line on this picture and look in the mirror to find out whether it is divided into equal parts or not?
Dadaji, for this picture, we will place the mirror on top of this line and we will see a similar picture.
You answered this correctly. Can you draw a dotted line on this picture and look at it in the mirror to find out whether we can divide it into equal parts or not?
Dadaji, I will be able to do it this time too. In this picture, when we place the mirror above this line, then we will get such a picture.
You answered this correctly too. Now draw a dotted line on this picture in such a way that half of it is visible on the mirror.
Oh Dadaji, this is a chessboard. I need to think a little about it.
If you want, you can pause the video here and give it a try.
I found it, Dadaji. Let's see this. In this picture, when we place the mirror above this line, then we will get such a picture.
Well done, Pinku. Now tell me, whether we can place the mirror on some other line?
Children, you also find and tell.
Yes, Dadaji. See this.
Well done, Pinku. You have answered all the questions correctly. Take your reward.
Dear children, till now you have seen some examples and understood that if we place the mirror on the correct dotted line, then even the incomplete pictures are visible to us. And it is not necessary that the dotted line is always vertical, it can also be diagonal. This is where we end this video. In the next video, we will discuss some common mistakes related to it. Thank you.
Welcome to this video. So far, we have seen some examples with Pinku. Now we will see the picture seen in the mirror with Pinku and some common mistakes related to the dotted line.
Pinku, till now you have seen so many pictures. Now I want to ask you some more questions. Will you be able to answer?
Yes, Dadaji, I will answer all the questions very easily.
Okay, Pinku. Then tell me, where will you draw the dotted line in this picture? By putting the mirror on one half, we can see the whole picture.
Dadaji, in this picture, we can draw the dotted line in this way.
Okay, Pinku. Now place the mirror in this place and see what is made.
Dadaji, it looks a little strange. When I face the mirror to the left, such a picture was made. And when turned it to the right side, it became like this. Why did this happen, Dadaji?
Because, Pinku, you drew the wrong dotted line. The correct dotted line will look something like this. Take this, Pinku. Now you see it in the mirror.
Yes, Dadaji. Now it is divided into two equal halves.
Pinku, always keep in mind that there is a different dotted line for every image. Pinku, look at this cartoon. Now place the mirror in such a way that both hands of this cartoon should be up in this way.
If you want, you can pause the video here and think.
Dadaji, this cartoon is very interesting. But how can both its hands be up? It has one hand up and one hand down, Dadaji.
Pinku, look carefully. If you place the mirror on this line and face the mirror to the right, you will get such a picture.
I'll keep the mirror once and see. Dadaji, both hands are up.
Pinku, can you now put both its hands down like this?
Yes, Dadaji. This time only the mirror has to face to the left and such a picture will be seen.
Dear children, till now you have seen how pictures change in front of the mirror. And you also learned that a dotted line is not always a vertical line. This line can be horizontal also. Now look at these pictures and tell, where should we place the mirror on this picture so that the following pictures could be seen? Till now you have seen how changing the place of the mirror changes the picture, and also learned to recognize the correct dotted line. Hope you have learned many things from Pinku's mistakes. And now you know about this subject very well. With this video ends here. Thank you. Children, welcome to this video. Today we will keep interesting figures in front of the mirror and look at them and discuss the dotted line. It will be a lot of fun.
Dadaji, come let us play something.
Come, Pinku. Let us play a game with the help of a mirror today.
With the help of a mirror? How, Dadaji?
Pinku, can you fold this picture into two equal parts?
Yes, Dadaji, I can do it.
Wow, Pinku, you have folded it correctly. Now open this paper and tell me if you see a line formed due to folding.
Yes, Dadaji. And this line is dividing this letter into two halves.
How did you find it?
Dadaji, this is very easy. With the help of this line, we had folded this picture and it looked exactly half. The left half has covered the right half completely.
Well done, Pinku. Now just put this mirror on this dotted line and see what happens.
Oh wow, Dadaji, this picture is complete. Now I see the entire letter A in it. Dadaji, this is a lot of fun. Now I will fold this letter the same way and see it in the mirror. Dadaji, this is a miracle. Now it has been divided into two equal halves. The top half has completely covered the bottom half.
Now keep a mirror on this dotted line and see.
By placing a mirror along with this line, I can see the whole picture.
Okay, now look at the picture of this butterfly. Can you divide this picture in half?
Yes, Dadaji, like this.
Well done, Pinku. Keep the mirror and see if the whole picture can be recreated.
Yes, Dadaji. I saw the whole picture as soon as the mirror was placed.
Pinku, now you play this mirror game with these letters too.
Okay, Dadaji.
Children, all of you also write some letters on paper and divide it into half. Keep a mirror and see.
Dear children, you must have had a lot of fun with the mirror game and must have learned a lot too. Do you know that this game can be played with any picture, not just the letters? The image formed on the mirror is called the mirror image. And a line that divides a picture into two equal parts is called a point line. In the next video, we will see this game played with even more fun pictures. We will meet in the next video. Thank you.
Children, welcome to this video. Today we will learn rotational symmetry and discuss the number of turns. A long time ago, a magician came to the court of the king Krishnadev Rai. He said to the king,
"Greetings, Your Highness. I am a famous magician from the neighboring kingdom."
"Oh, wow. I would like to see your talent."
"But, Your Highness, I have a condition. If I magically rotate an object given by you upside down, then you will have to give me 1,000 gold coins. I will come tomorrow to present my magic."
The magician said this and left. The king started thinking. The king called Tenali Raman, the greatest scholar of his kingdom, and told him everything. The magician arrived the next day and brought back a black box with him. He said to the king that if he keeps anything inside that box, it will rotate upside down. The king gestured to Tenali Raman. First, Tenali Raman placed a pot inside the box. The magician recited the magical words and opened the box. On opening the box, the pot had turned upside down. Now Tenali Raman placed the number 8 made of iron in the box upright. The magician recited the magical words and performed the magic. The moment the magician opened the box, he saw that the object was upright. Once again, the magician recited the magical words but could not succeed. Finally, he gave up, apologized to the king, and left. The king was very happy. He asked Tenali Raman,
"Tenali Ramaji, how did you get this idea?"
"Your Highness, to rotate an object means to turn it around a point. The magician said that he will rotate an object upside down. Like initially, the magician turned the pot upside down. In this manner, if you write 8 on a paper and rotate the paper like this, you will see 8 as it was before. This is called half rotational symmetry."
The king was very happy with Tenali Raman's cleverness.
"Tenali Ramaji, I will be able to do the same?"
"Yes, Your Highness, take this and rotate this by half."
"Wow, Tenali Ramaji, this is interesting. Is there any other object like this?"
"Can you please rotate it?"
"This one also has the same rotational symmetry."
"Your Highness, now you know a lot about rotation. Can you tell about an image that on rotating by 1/4 looks the same as before?"
The king was puzzled. You too try to find the answer to this question. We will share the answer to this question in the next video. In this video, we learned about such objects and images which change when rotated by half.
At the same time, we also saw some examples of objects which do not change when rotated by half. The images that look the same as before when rotated by half have half rotational symmetry, that is 1/2 rotational symmetry. Why don't you try to rotate such objects around you and observe? Thank you.
Friends, welcome to this video. In the last video, we learned about rotating objects by half and half rotational symmetry. In this video, we will learn about turning objects by a quarter and we'll look at examples related to them. The king meets Tenali Raman early in the morning.
"Tenali ji, I thought a lot about your question. Look at this shield of mine. Now let's look at it after turning it by 1/4. It looks the same as before. This shield is the answer to your question. This is called 1/4 rotational symmetry.
Your Highness, we will get a similar image if we rotate it by half.
To find this out, let's turn it and see. Look at this, Tenali Ramaji. It looks the same.
Wow, Your Highness.
Now you tell me an object that will look the same after rotating it by 1/4.
Tenali Raman looks here and there. His attention goes to an image on the wall. He pointed at that image and says,
Your Highness, look at that image. On rotating this image by 1/4, it will look the same.
Wow, you too managed to find an image.
Now you also find another image.
Why not? Look at this rangoli. If we rotate this image by 1/4, it will look the same.
Wow, Your Highness, you have managed to turn this beautiful rangoli as well. Your Highness, look at this image. What do you think about this?
Tenali Ramaji, come, let's turn it by 1/4 and see.
Your Highness, this looks different. Let's once turn it by half and see.
Tenali Ramaji, it still looks different. Why is it so, Tenali Ramaji?
Your Highness, it means that we cannot use half or 1/4 rotational symmetry with this image.
After this, both of them get busy searching for another type of images. Why don't you also try to find similar images near you?
In this video, we saw that some objects and images do not change even after turning by 1/4 or half. Such objects have 1/4 rotational symmetry and also have half rotational symmetry. And then there are some objects which have their image changed when they are turned by half or 1/4 part. In the next video, we will see some misconceptions and common mistakes related to these. Thank you.
Friends, welcome to this video. Today, we will see few misconceptions and common mistakes related to rotational symmetry and number of turns. In the previous video, we saw some examples related to rotational symmetry, half rotational symmetry, and 1/4 rotational symmetry. In today's video, we will see some misconceptions and common mistakes related to them. State whether the following sentence is true or false. The given images looks the same as before when turned by half. If you consider this statement true, then you must be thinking that on turning the image by half, it looks like before. Then you are not paying attention to the symbols on the image. If we turn the image by half, then the position of the symbols will change. On turning by half, this image does not look the same as before. Therefore, this statement is false. Come, now let's see another example. On rotating the given image by 1/4, it looks the same as before. If you wish, you can stop the video here and think about the answer. If you consider this statement as true, then you must be thinking that on rotating the image by half, it will again look like this. And if it looks like this after rotating by half, then it will look the same when rotated by 1/4 as well. But it is not so. Once again, take a closer look. When rotated by half, when rotated by 1/4, you must have seen that on rotating half, it looks the same, but doesn't look the same when rotated by 1/4. Therefore, it is not necessary that if an image looks like its original self when rotated by half,
then it would look the same when rotated by a quarter. Therefore, this statement is false. Come, let's look at another example. Can we get the same image by rotating the given image by half or rotating it by 1/4? If your answer is a yes, then think again. If we turn this image by 1/4, then it will look something like this. And if we rotate the original image by half, then it will look like this. You have seen here that under no circumstance does it look like before. Therefore, this statement is false. In this video, we learned that we should pay attention to even the small symbols marked on the image when rotating them by half or 1/4. And it is not necessary that if an image looks like the original when turned by half, then it will look like the original even when turned by 1/4. You also learned that it is not at all necessary that we get the original image by turning the image by half or 1/4. Hope you will take care of the important things mentioned in this video. Thank you. Welcome to this video. Till now you have learned about half rotation and 1/4 rotation. Today, in this video, we will learn about 1/3 and 1/6 rotation. Strange incidents were occurring in King Krishna Dev Rai's kingdom. Though the security was extremely tight, criminals still kept escaping from the prison. The king tried to change the locks, but still the incidents of escaping from the prison did not reduce. The king was worried and called for Tenali Rama, the noble scholar of his court. Tenali Rama checked both the old and new locks. After checking them, he asked the jailer, "Do you open the lock several times a day?"
"Yes, we have to open the prison many times a day."
Tenali Rama smiled and he said something to the jailer. Then he made some markings on the locks and returned to the king. Many months passed by, but there was no report of any escape since then. Then the king asked Tenali Rama,
"What did you do to the locks, Tenali Rama? No prisoner is able to escape these days."
"My lord, I keenly observed both the locks first. The shape of the first lock was such that it looked the same even after 1/3 rotation."
Dear students, let us understand the cleverness of Tenali Rama. Look at this picture. Let us rotate by 1/6. In order to do this, first of all, we will divide this figure into 6 equal parts with the help of 6 lines across the center. You can see that these 6 lines are passing through the center. If you have to do a 1/6 rotation, then rotate this picture in this way. If we have to do 1/3 rotation, then we will divide it into 3 equal parts across the center. Draw the lines in this way. You can see that 3 lines are passing through the center of this picture. Now rotate this picture in this manner and look at this 1/3 rotation. Now let us notice the objects around us with 1/3 and 1/6 rotation. Also, we will see how Tenali Rama helped King Krishnadev Rai and the kingdom use this concept. To close this lock, 1/3 rotation was needed. Then only it used to close.
But there was no difference in its shape even after the one-third rotation. Due to this, it was not possible to find whether the lock was open or closed. Since this lock has one-third rotational symmetry, jailer didn't realize that it was left open, and the prisoner got a chance to run away. When the lock was replaced, the shape of the new lock was like this. 1/6 rotation was needed to close this lock. Because of the 1/6 rotational symmetry in this lock, there would be no difference in its shape even after 1/6 rotation. Due to this, the prisoners got another chance to run away since the lock remained opened. To solve this problem, I painted one side of both the locks. This helped the jailer to identify whether the lock is open or closed.
How does that happen, Tenali Rama?
Look, I am going to show you by rotating this lock. Now it is open. And after rotating in this manner, it is closed.
Yes, Tenali Rama. Now I can see that it has rotated once. I understood your trick. It means that the other lock, which opens after 1/6 rotation, looks like this. And after closing, it will look like this. I am proud of your wisdom, Tenali Rama.
So, in this video, we have learned about some objects and their shapes which do not change after 1/3 and 1/6 rotation. The shapes and things which look the same even after 1/3 rotation represent 1/3 rotational symmetry. And the shapes which look the same even after 1/6 rotation represent 1/6 rotational symmetry. You also try to find similar objects around you and try to find their rotational symmetry. Thank you.
Friends, welcome to this video. In the last video, we learned about 1/3 and 1/6 rotational symmetry. Today, we will see some examples related to them. King Krishnadeva Rai and Tenali Rama were taking a walk in the garden.
Tenali Ramaji, you have solved the puzzle of locks with your wisdom. Can you name some more objects that will remain the same even after 1/3 rotation?
Yes, my lord. There are many objects and shapes like this. For example, look at the image on the flag. This image will remain the same even after rotating it by 1/3. Similarly, look at the other flag also. This image too will remain the same after rotating it 1/3.
Great, Tenali Rama. You have very well described the images with 1/3 rotational symmetry. Now show me some images with 1/6 rotational symmetry. Is there some image around us that will remain the same even after 1/6 rotation?
Sure, my lord. Let me search. Sir, please have a look at this flower very carefully. This flower has 6 parts. Whenever we make 1/6 rotation, it will remain the same as before.
Oh, this flower is beautiful. Let us take this back to the palace with us. Both of them left for the palace. Once they reached the palace, the king saw an image hanging on the wall. After pointing towards the image, he said, Tenali Rama, I think this image will also remain same after 1/6 rotation.
Sir, I also feel the same. Let us rotate it and see.
Tenali Rama rotated it. Oh yes, this image is also the same, even after 1/6 rotation. Very good, Tenali Rama. Now both the king and Tenali Rama want to take some rest. Children, in this video, we have seen some objects and shapes that do not change their shape even after 1/3 and 1/6 rotation. These objects have 1/3, that is 1/3 rotational symmetry, and 1/6, that is 1/6 rotational symmetry. In the next video, we will see some common mistakes related to them. Thank you. Friends, welcome to this video. In the last video, we have seen some examples related to 1/3 and 1/6 rotational symmetry. Today, we will see some common mistakes related to them. Answer whether the following statement is true or false. The given image remains the same even after 1/3 rotation. To find out, let us rotate it and take a look. Here the given image remains the same after 1/3 rotation. Thus, the given statement is true. Will this image too remain the same after 1/3 rotation? Let us rotate it by 1/3 and see for ourselves. This image does not match the earlier one. Since this image is colorful, we have to focus on the order of the colors also. All these parts have different colors. Thus, this is a false statement. Let us look at another example. You must have seen this circular wing. Look at it very carefully. Will it remain the same even after 1/6 rotation? Let us rotate it. You can pause the video and think for a while. This swing does not match with the earlier one after 1/6 rotation. Here, you have to focus on the shape of the cabins also. If the shape of the cabin is not same, then this swing does not match with the earlier one after rotation. Therefore, this statement is false. Children, will the symmetry change after 1/3 rotation? Let us rotate it and see. As you can see, it remains the same even after 1/3 rotation. Children, it is not necessary that the objects with 1/3 rotational symmetry will remain the same after 1/6 rotation. Children, look at these images and find out which images will remain the same after 1/3 or 1/6 rotation or both. Children, as you can see, that figure A and B are not changing after 1/3 rotation and 1/6 rotation. And figure C does not change after 1/3 rotation. After 1/6 rotation, it will change and look like this. Children, in this video, we learned that while rotating an image by 1/3 or 1/6, you should focus on the color and the shape of different parts. It is not necessary that we will get the original shape after 1/3 or 1/6 rotation. Thank you.